can't say I've arrived here in breathless because I came quickly. Anyhow, well, in the end, the plan that won out was to come here to you. And so I guess that even if I was to say ends up being meaningless, I better tell you nevertheless. You see, I've come grasping at the hope that at least I'll only suffer what I was fated to suffer anyway.
Get a move on, man. What troubles you?
First, please, let me tell you something about me. It wasn't me that did it, nor did I see who did it. So as that's the case, I couldn't possibly be punished for it, right?
Listen, it won't make any difference how much you try to defend yourself with excuses. You obviously have something to tell me.
Yes, and it's bad, and that makes a man very nervous.
Damn it! Just tell me right now, and then be on your way.
Yes, I'll tell you all right. That corpse, well, someone's buried it and then disappeared. They sprinkled it with the soil it craved and performed the customary rites.
What are you telling me? What man would dare to do that?
No idea. This was the work of someone who left no clues. The corpse had disappeared from sight. It wasn't exactly entombed, but rather covered in soil as if to prevent an offense to custom. No one here likes the messenger of bad tidings.
No, I tell you under oath that unless you find the very man who performed this burial and bring him here to me, you shall all be hanged alive as an example of what this kind of arrogance will bring.
Might I say something, or should I just turn and go?
Don't you realize even the sound of your voice angers me?
Do my words affect your ears or your mind?
Why are you trying to identify the source of my pain?
Well, it's the perpetrator of the deed that offends your mind. I only offend your ears.
Damn, you were clearly born a gibbering fool.
Maybe, but I did not commit the crime.
Yes, you did. At least you sold your soul for money.
No, it's terrible to believe in a lie just because you believe in it.
Don't offer me your wisdom about the nature of belief. Unless you find me who did this, you'll be an example of what suffering base greed can bring, or we will have to settle this with a draw.
This is the one that did the deed. We caught her burying him, but where's Creon?
What is going on? What has happened that makes my return timely?
You see, this girl was caught adorning the grave, and so I bring her here. No one drew any lots for this task. No, this was my piece of good luck and mine alone. So, my lord, take her, judge her, and convict her as best as you see fit. But I, in turn, should go and be free and justly absolved of any wrongdoings and not have to participate in the draw.
Are you sure that you are telling me the truth?
Absolutely. I saw her burying that corpse's burial you forbade. Isn't that clear and precise enough?
No. Tell me how she was first spotted and then caught right there.
Okay, here's the whole story.
You who are staring at your feet, speak up. Did you do this or do you deny it? I don't want any long explanations. Keep it brief. Did you know about the edict that forbade what you did?
Of course I knew about it. How couldn't I have? It was known by everyone.
Yet despite that, you dared to break the law?
Absolutely I did. What more could you want than to arrest me and execute me?
Nothing more. If I have that, I have everything. The good cannot be treated the same as the wicked. Well, we shall soon know better than your speculation. My son, you must have heard about the just decision that has been made regarding your bride-to-be. Have you come into anger at your father?
No, father, I am yours. You direct me with sound advice, and I follow. I cannot regard any marriage as more important than following you faithfully.
Never, son. Lose your mind for the sake of the pleasures a woman can give. But know that having a wicked woman in your bed at home is the same as putting your arms around something that is destined to freeze your heart. For what worse wound can suffer than finding the one that you love is evil? So come, declare this woman your enemy, renounce her, and send her to marry someone in Hades. For all of our citizens, she alone, I caught openly disobeying my orders. And you can be sure that I will not allow myself to be a liar in front of the city. No, I will kill her.
The average man is terrified to look you in the face and tell you things he knows will offend your hearing. But I can hear what is being said in secret. The townspeople weep for this girl and say that she is not right, that it is not right that she should suffer a horrible death for doing what any woman would consider a source of great pride. Let your anger go and be willing to change.
Nonsense. Do you really think that men of my age are to be taught the nature of wisdom by a man of your age?
Only if I see something that is not just.
It is not up to the townspeople to tell me what commands I ought to give.
If you rule alone, you will be the great ruler of a deserted land.
It seems as though my son is on that woman's side.
Only if you are that woman before. I only care about you.
You show your care by lambasting me, you bastard.
Only because I see you failing at being just.
Your set of values is worse than a woman's.